Welcome to the Great Exodus series, God's plan for rescue for all of his children. Let my people go, the path to Mount Zion, the holy mountain, to the dwelling place of the Father, of Yahweh, where his throne of glory will be standing, the mountain not carved by human hands. My name is Michael. I am the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And I welcome you to our new topic today, You Cannot Serve Two Masters. Many people, and especially many Christians, are trying to do that impossible. Do the impossible. They try to juggle and balance two masters. They want to stay in the world, and at the same time, they want to serve the Lord and want to serve Yahweh. That is not possible. Read it in your Bible. You cannot serve two masters. Either you will be perfect for one and then disappoint the other, or you will disappoint God and please Satan. There's no way for you to do both. But most people are still in their careers, in their families, in their houses, in their riches, in their luxuries. They are still in the world. And at the same time, they claim to be the bride. They claim to be true Christians. Now, if you are seeking the pleasures in the world, then you cannot seek the heavenly kingdom. You cannot serve two masters. You have to understand that. You have to choose. And you have to choose now, because the escape of the bride is at hand. If you are not going, then you will be the remnant, a tribulation saint. Not, of course, of the tribulation period of the trumpets, but of the sealed tribulation period. Many people have no understanding about the true time frame. They think everything has to be fit in 7 years. What is absolutely wrong. This is not true. We have three raptures, or put it in brackets, so-called raptures. The first is not a rapture. The first is the escape of the bride, a vanishing into the clouds. The world will not see Jesus. Only the bride will see Jesus, and they will disappear. Many people will disappear from this earth. Suddenly, children, firstborn, and the truly and beloved bride of Christ. But this is not a rapture. This is an escape. And then we have the second rapture of the remnant, the true rapture of the church, the multitude clothed in white, will take place at the sixth seal, and you will be raptured into paradise at Mount Zion. This is a great group. This is the harvest of the ages. A number that nobody could count. So great. From all over the world. And the angels will collect the people from all the assemblies of love and righteousness, the societies of the rose, from all over the world, from other places where they have made themselves ready, and will bring them down to Mount Zion. And there we will have access to the holy place, to the Father. There we will lay our heart at his feet. But until then, we have to repent daily and do the righteous deeds of the saints, so that we can change our garments to white clothes. Because the white clothes will give us the access to paradise. Then we have a third rapture. That will then have to do with a left behind of the field, the corners of the field that not yet gleaned, and with the Jewish people. That will also happen, most likely just before or at the time when Jesus will step down on Mount of Olives. That's a third rapture. And in the same way as we have three so-called raptures, we also have three time frames. And the first time frame started 2011-2012 and finished in 2018 to 19. And this was the easy years, 7 easy years, where it was very easy for you to take hold of the Holy Spirit, to pray, to be in contact with the Lord, everything very easy, because your surrounding is protected, you have a good life. It was very easy for you to be in contact with heaven. Then this will be followed by 7 years of seal tribulations. This will start now, 2019, and will go to 2025 to 26. And there we will have the rapture at the sixth seal, the year 2024 to 2025. Clearly stated all over in the Bible. Look at the book of Revelation. Look at Daniel. Look at so many other prophets. And there the multitude in white will go into the rapture to paradise. Then after that, we will have this 7-year period that everybody is referring to. This is the third 7-year period. The trumpet and bowl period. This is the time in the middle when Satan will come down onto the earth in 2028 to 2029. And this will end at 2032 with Jesus coming down, or 31 or 32, I don't know, 100%. When Jesus will step down on the Mount of Olives, then we have 1-year jubilee period. And all will be finished in 2033. And the millennium will start. We have three 7-year periods, starting to 2011, 2012, and ending with the 1-year jubilee period in 2033. Exactly as it is prophesied, 2 days or 2,000 years after Jesus died on the cross. Because everything what is written in the scriptures must be fulfilled. Everything. And it will. Nothing will be left out. Because this is the word of Yahweh, of the Father, of God. So if you look at a 7-year period and try to push everything in 1 7-year period, you must fail. And that's the reason why there's so much confusion. People say, oh, this, people say that, oh, this cannot happen, oh, this cannot fit together. No, then it must be, oh, this can only be 5 days and this must be 6 days because otherwise it cannot fit. Of course it cannot fit. Cannot fit because you try to push everything into a 7-year period when in reality we have 777. And people were fighting about, oh, pre-trip, mid-trip, and post-trip, when in reality, everything was true. There is a pre-trip escape of the bride. There is a mid-trip escape of the multitude, the remnant, the tribulation saints. And there is a post-trip of the Jewish people and the corners of the field. And who is working in that for that post-trip rapture? Who will help the people there, this leftovers for the corners of the field? 144,000. It is written in Revelation. Open up the books. It is there. They will be there during the time of trumpets. And that's the reason why they get special powers, because this will be the worst time. And this will be the time when the pit will be opened. And when Satan will come down onto the earth. The two witnesses will be there also. Multitude and white will be gone. The bride will be gone for a long time, for years. Think about it. Put yourself a new time frame, and then everything will fall into place. your whole understanding and all your visions and all your dreams will fit in perfectly. But no matter to what conclusion you are coming, the most important part is that you cannot serve two masters. And that's the reason why we are calling you out of the world and out of Babylon. Somebody sent me a comment and he said, Babylon is not there because it just only appears in Zechariah 5. Then he has never read Zechariah 2, where it's clearly written and said that Zion has to leave Babylon. That is Zechariah 2. And Zechariah 2 is about the time frame of end of this year to next year. So we are there. And then if Zechariah 2 is true, then of course Babylon must be there. And Babylon is not only the Babylon in the land of China, as it is written in Zechariah 5. That maybe will be the headquarter for that Babylon at this time. If we are thinking that most of our disputes and thinking over special verses or so will come up as threefold, then also Babylon must have a threefold meaning. Babylon in Iraq, maybe Babylon as Rome, and maybe Babylon as false doctrines and false churches. Just open your mind. Do not be so fixed on your false teachers. Open your mind. Look over the plate, over the corners of the plate, and see how can everything fit in? How can it work together? The number three, there is a reason why there is a trinity. There is a reason why the number three is so prominent in the word. Because everything is in threefold. I have made a whole video about that, about patterns and threefold meaning and all that. Have a look at it. Look for it in our YouTube channel. It's there. About biblical pattern, or pattern in the Bible. But please, for today, I want to close. I want to tell you, you cannot serve two masters. Stay out of the world and out of Babylon. And join us to walk that narrow and straight path to Mount Zion. Not go to the right, not go to the left, but walk straight to the glory throne of the Father at Mount Zion. Join us. Become a member of our website Triple Grace. Ask your question at triplegrace55@gmail.com. Have a look at our YouTube channel. Watch the videos until the end. And remember that when darkness falls and judgment strikes, then we are here. We are here for you. And we walk with you, hand by hand, to Mount Zion, where we will be raptured into paradise. Everything what we are teaching is written in the Bible. Do not follow the false doctrines of prosperity, of poverty, of false grace, of all that, once saved, always saved. Do not follow it. This is made to put you in a state of complacency so that you remain seated in your church benches, so that you do not walk that path. They want to lull you into a sleep instead to bring you forth towards the mountain. They don't want that you will go to the mountain. They don't want that you will see the glory of the Father. They want to keep you in the enemy territory. They want to keep you close to Satan. He's very clever, but remember that he only copies. He has nothing original. He is only a copycat. And everything what you see that he uses will also be used on the positive side in the kingdom of heaven, because he has created nothing. So if there is a worldly economy, then there also must be a heavenly economy. And we have proven that times over times, that the heavenly economy is about winning souls. And you should be a harvest worker. But the worldly, satanic economy is about working for money. There are riches in the world, a Ferrari, a big house, whatever. And there are riches in the heavenly kingdom, the crowns of glory that you will receive for your good works that you have done as a person who is saved, truly saved, and as a person who abides in Jesus Christ, and who is not believing in a false doctrine and will remain seated and wait for the coming of the Lord. The Lord will come, but then he will say, I do not know you, because you have not done anything for me. So do not serve two masters. This was our topic for today. My name is Michael. May God bless you and your family abundantly. Please think especially about the time frames and the number 3 in the Bible, and that everything is threefold. Maybe now many of your dreams and prophecy and visions will fit. And take part in our dual Passover to Heaven timeline from the 6th of July to the 13th of July. If you need more information about that, please watch our daily prophetic words. Watch all the videos. Sign up for Triple Grace. Send me your questions. And if you're guided, please support our full-time ministry so that we can bring the message out to all the people that there's hope for you, hope of the Lord, and the hope of Mount Zion. I love you all so dearly. And if you like to support us in any financial way, the links are in the donation box below, in the description box below. And there are the links for your donations. Have a great day, and I will see you again tomorrow. Maranatha.